Suppose you create your own team. A new person appears there, who seems to be interested in the work, seemingly wants to achieve the goals he talks about, and even willing to put in the necessary effort. But actually, he does not show initiative. He has doubts all the time. He wants you to give him the necessary prompts to make decisions. He complains constantly that he can't do it, or that expected more. You feel you're spending a lot of effort and energy on working with this person, while the return is minimal. Is it worth trying to persuade someone such as an employee, partner, or customer? I'm often asked this question. In any matter, especially in business, it's very important to note how many resources you spend and what's the result you receive. If you don't calculate your expenses, you'll start operating at a loss. Does it make sense to run such a business or do this kind of work? You and I understand perfectly that an activity should generate income. Only then there's sense in doing it. What happens when you practice persuasion? First of all, you waste your time. Time is irreplaceable. Having spent it on something useless and ineffective, you'll no longer be able to return it or use it again more sensibly. Not to mention the squandered opportunities. You can simply calculate the direct costs, as every hour of your time has value. Therefore, by wasting few hours, you've lost a certain amount of money. There are also other financial costs. For example, you go to a meet with a hesitant client. Does this entail expenses on your part? Of course it does. Transportation, preparation of presentation materials, even coffee, all this is money that have you spent on a useless meeting. And the most interesting thing is that, as a rule, this isn't the first meeting with your client. You've met with him on more than one occasion, all the time trying to convince him to buy your product. The client does not refuse the meetings, but does not display interest either. The senseless pseudo-sale continues for a long time while draining away your strength and devouring your money. But this is not all. There's another important thing. By engaging in immaterial persuasion, you lose confidence in yourself and your product. You constantly lower your self-esteem. As a result, you lose the ability to act effectively, even when there are truly promising opportunities in front of you. I always say, while you're persuading one person, I'll have time to get round 10. Also, those whom eventually manage to persuade will often demand very large concessions from you. For instance, the maximum discount, and they still won't be completely satisfied. This will always complain without something and exhaust you with their petty demands. And more often than not, they won't want to continue cooperation. They won't want to make further purchases. And you can forget about the useful recommendations and reviews from them. This is not only true in sales, but it's true for anything else. Seek those who want to work with you. Seek those who want to buy from you, who are interested in you. That is, choose your partners for yourself. Do not hold on to those who have their doubts or who expect you to be their nanny. Invest your time, money, effort, and energy into something that will bear you greatest fruit. Look after it, fertilize it, water your blooming garden, instead of trying to at least grow something on a rocky cliff. Only those who want to do business with you will gladly accept your offer, and they will be grateful to you and want to establish a long-term relationship, fruitful relationship with you.